Hello students, let us start our new session with the new topic, relation between field and potential. Consider our two equipotential surfaces A and B. Surface A has a potential V. Surface B is a part at the distance delta L, and potential is increases by delta V. So at the surface B, the total potential value is V plus delta V. Now let us assume that point P is available on the center electric field line on the surface P. Now a unit charge is moving perpendicular from surface B to A against electric field. Our electric field is A to B, outward side is there, right? Then what we want to do? A point charge we want to move from surface B to A. So against the electric field we need to do a work. So work done in this field is E into delta L. E is the energy level and delta L is the distance between these two surfaces. So we can say this is a work done is nothing but potential difference between A and B. So VA minus VB. So E delta L is nothing but VA minus VB. So V is the potential at surface A and V plus delta V is the potential at surface B. So we can say E delta L equals to V minus V plus delta V. So equals to minus delta V. So E is minus delta V by delta L. Right? So here two points we can conclude from it. Electric field is in the direction in which the potential decreases. And another point is, its magnitude is given by the change in magnitude of potential per unit displacement normal to the equipotential surface at the point. These two points we are defining based on the equation we derived, E equals to delta V by delta L. Now next point, potential energy of a system of charges. So consider first the simple case of two charges Q1 and Q2 with position vector R1 and R2 relating to the same origin. Now we want to calculate a work done. So the work done for that, charges Q1 and Q2 are initially at infinite and we need to determine the work done by an external force applied to bring these charges from the infinity to the given location. Right? Two charges are there, Q1 and Q2. We want to bring it at some location. For that we need to provide external field and origin point we consider same. These two charges over which we are applying a force one by one. First we are assuming that we are taking charge Q1. We are applying external force over it and we are bringing it from infinity, at which point from the origin point to the R1 distance. So from the origin, apart at the R1 distance, we need to place Q1. Right? But here, no other charges are available. So, no work done is present between electric field of charges. So here just the work done is available based on the external force, and that is Q1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 R1P. Now we need to bring a charge Q2 from infinite. So for that again we are providing external field, but while we are bringing it, Q1 charge is already present in the system. An external force we are applying. So as the Q1 charge is there, its electric field is already available, and we are providing external force as well over it. So the total work done is Q1 into Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 R12. So thus that potential energy we have available between these two charges, Q1, Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 R12. If Q1, Q2 is greater than 0, it means the charges is positive, then we need to provide a positive work done to get the charges from infinity to a defined point. But if Q1 and Q2 charges are negative, then we need to provide a positive work done to move these charges from the given location to infinity. I repeat, if charges are positive, positive work done is required to bring it from infinity to desired location. Now the locations are different for negative. Be focused. If charges are negative, then work done is required positive to move these charges from the desired location to infinity. The reverse condition is arrived over here. So we can say that when charges are negative, negative potential energy is there, and if charges are positive, positive potential energy is available. Now consider that in a system, three charges are there, Q1, Q2 and Q3, and they are apart at the location R1, R2 and R3. First we are bringing Q1 from the infinity, no other charges are available. So work done is required 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R12. Now if we want to bring a Q2 from the infinity, so external potential as well as electric field due to Q1 is available. Right? So for that, between Q1 and Q2, the potential is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 by R1P plus Q2 by R2P. Now if we want to bring a Q3 from the infinity, then potential is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q3 by 1 by R13 plus Q2 Q3 by R23. Right? Now based on the superposition, combine all the potentials, so my total work done is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R12, that is for Q2 we are bringing from infinity, and other two quantities Q1 Q3 by R13 and Q2 Q3 by R23, that is because of Q3 we are bringing from infinity. Right? So this is how we can be able to calculate a potential energy of a system. Let us go through example regarding this. The square is defined. Over this square, different charges are there. On the point A, positive charge is there. On point B, negative charge is there. On point C, positive charge is there, and on point D, negative charge is there. So the question is there. First one, find out the work required to put together this arrangement. Second, B point, a charge Q0 is brought to the center E of the square. The four charges being held fixed at its corner. How much extra work is needed to do this? What we need to do? This four corners are there. Four charges plus at A plus Q, at B minus Q, at C plus Q and at D minus Q is there. Here, first we are bringing a plus Q charge at A. So, we are assuming that remaining all charges are not available. First, we are taking charge Q at point A. So, for that, no work done is required or no potential difference is required within that system. Now, what we need to do? We are bringing a minus Q charge to B. At that time, plus Q charge at A is already available. So, how much work done is required? Minus Q, we need to bring on the B. So, minus Q, that charge minus Q into the work done potential positive Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 D. D is the distance between A and B point. So, total work done is minus Q square by 4 pi epsilon 0 D. Now, we are bringing plus Q at C. At that time, plus Q at A and minus Q at B is already available. So, what is the work done is required? Charge at C plus Q into the potential at C due to charges A and B. So, that is due to the A, Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 D by root 2. Why? Because it is a diagonally apart. At A and B or in the square, D distance is there. So, while A and C are diagonally apart, so that distance is D by root 2 plus potential due to B is minus Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 D. So, the resultant value is minus Q square by 4 pi epsilon 0 D into 1 minus 1 by root 2. Now, we are bringing a fourth and the last charge minus Q to the D. At that time, all these three charges are available. So, what is the work done is required? Charge on the D minus Q into the potential at D due to A, B and C. So, potential at A, Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 D. Potential at B is minus Q 4 pi epsilon 0 D by root 2 because B and D now diagonally apart. So, that distance we consider as D into root 2 plus potential at C Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 D. So, the resultant value is minus Q square by 4 pi epsilon 0 D into 2 minus 1 by root 2. Right. Now, combine all four work done. So, the final result is minus Q square by 4 pi epsilon 0 D into 4 minus root 2. Now, the next question is part B. If we are putting a charge Q0 at the center of the square, what will happen? At the center of the square, the resultant charge value is 0 because at all four points, different polarities are there. Diagonal points A and C have positive charges plus Q and the remaining two diagonal points B and D having the negative charges minus Q. So, at the center, the resultant value is 0 So we can say that no work done is required to bring a charge Q0 at the center E. Clear? Now let us focus on to the next point, potential energy in an external field. So now external electric field is available and we need to find out its potential energy. So again here we are taking three cases: potential energy of a single charge, potential energy of two charges, and potential energy of a dipole. So first case, potential energy of a single charge. So what we need to do over here, we want to determine the potential energy of a given charge Q in the external field. We are not focusing on the potential energy due to the external field or potential energy of Q on the external field. I repeat, we are interested to determine the potential energy of a charge Q in the external field, right? But we are not focusing onto the potential energy available due to external field or the potential energy generated by Q on the external field. This thing we are not interested. Are you getting my point? So here, electric field E is produced by the source of external field. We are assuming that Q does not significantly affect onto the sources because we are taking Q is very small, or if the distance is infinity between Q and the source, then also Q is not affected onto the external source. We are just interested if the external force is available. Based on that external force, what is the potential energy of Q? So now, if the electric field E is available and external potential V is available, so what will happen? External field is varying from point to point. By that definition, V potential is available at point P. So work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to P. Then work done is bringing a charge Q from infinity to P, that we can say Q into V. Work done is Q into potential, that is a V, right? So what will happen if Q is at the distance R is available from the external field, then my work done is Q into V of R. V of R is external potential at point R distance, right? Okay, so this is what my work done is available. Now, if that my charge Q, that is electron, and electron charge is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb, that is accelerated by a potential difference, for example, 1 volt. So Q into delta V, how much energy or the work done energy is required? 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. Joule is the unit of work done. This unit of energy is defined as a 1 electron volt. So that 1 electron volt is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. It is very important while we study its energy diagram to move that charge from one energy level to another energy level. Now, second point, potential energy of a system of two charges in an external field. So earlier point in which we focusing on the single charge, now we consider two charges are available. So work done on the single charge, on the single charge Q into V of R. Now two charges are there. Again apply superposition theorem. Two charges Q1 and Q2 are there. So onto the Q1, work done is Q1 into VR1. And onto the charge Q2, work done due to the external field is Q2 into VR2. But over here again, between two charges, electric field is available. So based on that, work done is Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 R12. I repeat, due to the external field, work done is Q into V of R. But due to the electric field present between two charges, we are applying Coulomb's law. And that is Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 R12. So again, based on that superposition, combine these two components of the work done on Q2, that Q2 VR2, that is due to the external field, plus Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 R1 due to electric field between R Q1 and Q2. So work done based on R1, Q1 to Q2. So the total potential energy of a system based on the two charges Q1 V R1, that is a potential on Q1, plus Q2 VR2, that is a potential on Q2 due to external force, plus Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 R1, that potential that between charges Q1 and Q2. Now, the third point, potential energy of a dipole in an external field. Dipole is there, so at two ends, opposite charges are available, plus Q and minus Q. While these two opposite charges are there and we are applying a external force, so the whole dipole is rotating basically. And that's why here actually the torque is generated. That torque is defined as P into E. That torque is P into E. So external torque is T external is there. And while we apply this T external, my dipole is rotating at the angle theta 0 to theta 1. And based on that, my total work done is integration of that external given torque is PE sin theta. And why we are replacing the sin theta? That is the difference between two cos angles, cos theta 0, the initial theta or initial angle is there. And after applying the external torque at theta 1, that is a cos theta 1. Right, what we are doing, we are applying an integration of that given external torque between theta 0 to theta 1. That external torque is PE sin theta. So the integration of sin is cos, apply the limit cos theta 0 minus cos theta 1. So based on that, if we are saying that while we are applying the external force, the initial my theta 0 is pi by 2. For example, my theta 0 is pi by 2 and the angle where it reach that theta 1 is, for example, defined as a normal theta. So my resultant value is PE cos pi by 2 minus cos theta. Cos pi by 2 is 0. So minus PE cos theta. So that is minus P dot E. If it would be cross, we are applying sine as earlier, and if it is a cos, we are applying a dot. That is the vector formulas are there. So the potential energy expression is Q into V, and this V is a potential difference. Potential at R1 minus potential at R2. That is due to the external torque, and the torque or the energy potential is present between two charges plus Q and minus Q is Q square, because both have the same charge. Q square by 4 pi epsilon 0 2a is dipole length is 2a. So these two charges are apart at the distance 2a. So now the potential difference between two positions r1 and r2 equals the work done in bringing a positive charge against the field from r2 to r1. So the total displacement parallel to the force is 2a cos theta, and thus vr1 minus vr2 is minus e into 2a cos theta. So replace the value that our u dash theta is minus pe cos theta minus q square 4 pi epsilon 0 to a. So that is minus p into e q square by 4 pi epsilon 0 to a. So is theta 0 is pi by 2, external field e is bringing, plus q and minus q are equal and opposite, and that's why vr1 minus vr2 is 0. So just a work done is required due to the electric field present between two charges only. External force is not affected. Right? Here we are going to end our this session. Hope you understood. Thank you.